What's going on, guys? Thank you for tuning into another episode. We got Andrew here eating my cheese Danish from Porto's. If you guys haven't had that, you guys should. But it's only in SoCal, though. First of all, let me just go over his cars. So first, he has a 02 or 03?
03.
03 broken WRX.
It's not broken yet.
He broke that one on a toge run, like a while ago. Now he has a 2000 SI. 99 SI, and that broke on the toge last night. This bad boy don't survive, bro. Oh, he's giving him that action. But little SI that could broke. He got to check engine light. We think it's the intake air control valve because his idle keeps bouncing, and it's pretty shitty. But today we're actually gonna go to Jose so that he can work on my car. We're leaving it there, and then Andrew can. I know Andrew's gonna do. Andrew's probably gonna get his car checked out, and then hopefully we can get it fixed today.
Get that startup, baby. Get that startup, Andrew.
That B16 sound good, bro.
Damn. But the real deal is my car.
My car's so much better.
Oh shit, why? I think sensitive, that's why, guys. I have a sensitive bitch.
See, my car doesn't have problems because, you know, I kept it with maintenance other than Andrew over there. Always breaking his cars, but see this thing start up. Oh, I also put this shift knob in because it's so much easier. Oops, sorry. This shift knob's so much easier to shift with other than the Mishimoto one just because this one's shorter and it's more direct. And I feel like I could shift a lot better with this one, so I changed it. But yeah, let's turn on the car. See? Easy peasy, babe. Oh, shout out to Andrew yesterday for giving me this Eurobeaters sticker. I think his friend or cousin owns the brand and then they make clothes for it, but I thought this was sick, so he gave it to me. I'm gonna put it on there just because, you know, yesterday I gave him that toge feel, you know what I'm saying? I was on his ass the whole time, man. I felt like Takumi! He's on Skyline Boulevard, by the way. So, if you don't know, in Skyline Boulevard, like if you keep going all the way down, like near Half Moon Bay, I think, there's like a bunch of twisties, and yeah, it was a pretty fun night. Crazy thing is that like a cop was actually down there and talked to us. He was like, "How you guys doing?" And I was like, "Hello, officer. We're just here for a Monday night cruise at like freaking like 12:45 in the morning." And then he already knew because some crap happened there with his kid, where like these two kids, they I think like they fell off a cliff doing a toge run there. So yeah, we're being careful, not doing too much. But yeah, this whole setup that I got going on feels really great. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to O'Reilly real quick because I have to go pick up some oil and some coolant so that Jose can fix a lot of my stuff, and I'll tell you guys later on what he's gonna do. And then we're gonna go back to Antioch and work on the SI because I need that thing running while Jose has my car here. So yeah, catch you guys in a bit. We're now at O'Reilly's. Let's see if Andrew got bars. It's a tight spot, dude. I don't think he can do it. Oh boy, oh boy. Well, I mean, our cars are hella small too, so it's like I'm pretty sure he could fit. But yeah, that's I actually really like that blue on the SI. There's blue, red, and then there's a white on the 99 to, no, there's blue, red, and black on the 99 to 2000 SI, so I think those are sick, but yeah. We're at O'Reilly now, so let's go get that coolant, the 50-50 coolant, as well as some oil. All right, guys, so we're done. What I got was the Mobil 1 Super Synthetic, full synthetic, and I don't know, they got me with this, bro, the high temp protection, because I am going to bring this car to the track. Oh, I didn't even tell you guys that. I'll tell you guys that in a bit. But then I also got the Peak 50-50 coolant here. So now Andrew is going to drive my car.
We traded.
We traded cars, so now I have two SIs. Andrew got this race car and a Subi, so see you later, dude. Drive safe. So yeah, so we're going to get into the SI now. Oh my god, dude, this car looks broken, bro. It's a beat ass Honda. Come on, Andrew. Ooh, but it is comfy though. Getting in this compared to getting into mine now, it's pretty comfy. Hello? Can we just appreciate? Woo! Looking clean! And this guy over here with his check engine light.
It's no bueno.
Hopefully it's the IACV, intake air control valve. If not, Andrew's gonna be broke, bro. By the end of this, his Subi's gonna break. This car's gonna, everything's gonna break, so. Oh my God, Andrew, what are you doing? So stupid. He doesn't even know how to drive. Oh my gosh, Andrew. Oh, not gonna lie though, this car drives pretty good. It's crazy how the, B16, I'm at like 70 miles per hour and it's already at 4K. Like, I don't know why. Oh, we got a ricer over here. Woo-wee! Man, I love that car. To be honest, I used to hate the coupe, but now I'm really digging the coupe. Coupe looks cool. I wish I had the hatch, but the coupe is fine. Yeah, I know a lot of you guys don't really like watching the EK, but I hope you guys are like welcome to it, because I'm doing a lot more stuff with the EK than I am with the SI right now. I have something big coming for the SI at the moment. I'm going to work on it behind the scenes, but once it comes and once I'm like ready to show you guys, I'll show you guys. But yeah, one of the things I didn't want to tell you guys is that this car, the EK up there, is actually gonna go hit the track on July 20th. I already paid for my registration. I just need to buy a helmet with my friend Joey. Yeah, that car is going on a track, Thunderhill East, on July 20th. It's gonna be my first track day, so it's gonna be a lot of fun. I'm gonna bring you guys along with me. But yeah, this is gonna be one step closer into finally tracking the car, because I know I kind of built this car first before I even went to the track, so it's like a lot of people are gonna bag on me or hate on me that I built it before I even hit the track. I didn't even get any seat time, but I wanted to get the things I already knew I was gonna need to change along the way done. So then now I have all the safety stuff. I just need the seat time, and then I could upgrade stuff from there, because I think the next thing I want to buy is motor mounts, because mine are pretty much shot. But thank you guys anyways for watching this content. I know like half of my subscribers or half of the views that I get from my SI watch this stuff, so thank you guys, I really appreciate it. And I'm gonna try to keep it revolved more around Civics. If not, I'll still show you guys some dope cars along the way. Alright guys, we got the track car here. So I'm just gonna go over with you what Jose is gonna be doing to my car, because it is kind of a lot. So first off, what Jose is gonna do is he's gonna replace coolant. Got that 50-50 coolant, got that 5WD-30 new oil for him. What we got is the we got the front blocks kit. Now he just needs to install the rear blocks kit right here. So you got the rear camber kit for the car that we still need to install so we can get a better alignment. We have the I mean, I could have done this, but since he's doing everything on my car already, he might as well. He's gonna do everything. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hold on. So we're gonna do this. NGK spark plug wires. We got the NGK G power spark plugs. Then we got the water pump timing belt that he's gonna do as well. And we also have a new oil pan gasket that he's gonna do. So we're gonna try to make this thing leak free as possible. So we'll see how it goes. All right guys, so Civic's gonna sit here. I'm gonna go back to Antioch, see if I can work on the SI, get the bag all situated, and then that'll be the end of this video.
Oh, yeah, boy.
Woo, that low life.
Go forward. You're already there, fuck it. Go forward.
Yeah. Now we're gonna get Phil's, cause we're kinda done with cars for today.
We were gonna go to Phil's on Ocean, but Andrew's car is still messing up. We tried to clear the IAC, but it's still, where is it? It's like at 1500 right now?
Yeah, it's at 15.
Yeah, it's at 1500 right now. When I pulled that vacuum line, I was at 1500 too, the whole time.
Oh, so maybe there's a vacuum leak.
It might be a vacuum leak, but that's why you have the little nipples, right? Because Patrick gave me one of these nipples that you can get from somewhere pretty cheap. It's like one of these. And I put that on where my cruise control was and it fixed my idle. So I'm back at like 300, 400 idle.
Oh, you need a nipple?
Oh, baby girl. Baby, ooh, the VTEC. Dude, this car is pretty fun, I'm not gonna lie. B16 is pretty lit. So that's what I might be going with, just to keep it strictly Honda and somewhat drop in like a drop-in motor. I know GSR drops into my car too, but I feel like I'd want to stick with B16 because I'm pretty sure I'm gonna keep it NA. I wouldn't want to boost it or anything like that as of right now, but damn, bro, this guy playing the music, bro, like, shut up. But yeah, dude, like, driving in this car, finally feeling a B16, I really dig it. I really dig the B16. So if anybody has a motor that's a V16 A2, please let me know down in the comments below and I will buy it off of you. Only for a good deal though, because your boy broke. But yeah, we're gonna get coffee. Then I'm heading out to Antioch. And I'll probably won't even work on the SI, to be quite honest. I'm just lazy as shit, so catch you guys in a bit. We are back at my house. As you can see right here, the SI has just been sitting. It's been like this for like a week. I even have the bumper on top of the roof. It's not too good. I shouldn't be doing that, but I didn't have any more room because my dad parked in the garage. But yeah, today we're actually going to be fixing the rear trunk because my second compressor doesn't turn on and I already recalibrated to it, just stopped working. And I think I'm just going to get rid of the wood that's on here. I also have, I don't have any of the shocks put on as of right now because I have, I just don't have the shocks on and I emptied out the tank. Yeah, let's get today started. I also want to like install this too because it's something so I can like fill up my tank or fill up my tires with. So yeah, today is just gonna be a whole lot of fixing, a lot of shit, cause there's a lot of shit wrong with this car. And shout out to my boy Alex, cause I traded his shocks for my shocks. I had BC Racing shocks on my car, but I traded for his AirTech air shocks. So yeah, let's get today started. Let's work on the car. So right now I'm just going over through the installation manual because when you have like six guys working on your car to install lines on one day, things start to you start to like miss a lot of things. So right now I'm doing the pressure relief valve, which I didn't do, or we didn't do, causing this to blow all the time. So now that we have this, I'm gonna do it the right way and try to see if I can get everything perfect with these lines, because this is probably one of the most important things that you should not miss. This done, this is gonna be a T that goes, I believe, in the middle of this, so we can have it like that. I mean, I only have this much 1/4 line left, so I'm probably gonna buy more, but this should fix it. So right now it's like this, it'll mount onto the bottom of the tank, and then we'll have this relief right here so that it's not gonna cause so much pressure that this is gonna blow like last time. So yeah, it's very important that you have this so it doesn't overpressurize. So yeah. So one of the things that is actually wrong with why my second compressor wasn't turning on was because this black wire right here wasn't connected to the black wire that's on the harness, and it like came off. So what I'm gonna do is I put this heat shrink one on, I'm gonna crimp it together, and then after that we'll heat shrink this so it doesn't come off ever again, and then we'll also electrical tape it just to make sure it's secure. All right, we got the black wire all ready. The red wire is still intact too, so that's good. The second compressor should be working now. Now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna clean up this mess. I also gotta fix, my rear bag. I don't know if some of you know, but I do have a slow leak in my rear bag. It might be because of this crimp steel braided line, but from our inspection when me and Jose did it at a shop is that it is leaking from the bottom of the bag right here. So I'm gonna take this out, re-thread it so that, see, because you can see right there that a lot of the a lot of the thread, I forgot what it's called, little thing, this thing right here is like coming out. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this off, Teflon tape it. There it is. Re-Teflon tape it and then put it back. So that should be good enough. I didn't put an overbearing amount because I didn't want it to like unlatch from where I was threading it in. So hopefully this fixes our issue. So now we can put it through the hole. So, and then put back the bat. All right, guys, we got
charger.
Dang, he thought I was talking to them. Now he feels awkward, huh? All
right, guys, so we got everything all situated in the back. Second compressor works now. I got the, I need more 1/4 lines so I could run this outside the car, but right now this works fine. So I could still take out the air out of the tank. Right now my car is dead. I haven't driven it in like 3 weeks, so it's on the jumper cables right now charging. Hopefully I don't have to go back to like AutoZone to get this battery recharged, because I don't want to do that, it takes too long. But yeah, it's on the jumper cables right now.
Damn, he still feels hella awkward that he thought I was talking to them. Damn.
How hey, follow me on IG.
No.
That was messy. Juicy juice, bruh.
My god, that was so ugly.
But yeah, that's gonna end it for today's video. Make sure you guys hit that subscribe button, hit that like button. Make sure you guys build humbly. Until next time, I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.